Today we're setting up an experiment to find out something that you've been frankly too inconsiderate to ever ask.
Does rice have feelings?
We're going to recreate an experiment that tries to show that our intent and our feelings have an effect on the world around us.
Really?
Really. So we're, all right. We're recreating an original experiment created by Dr. Emoto in whatever year. I don't really pay attention to these things. How it works is, Donovan and I are each gonna take 3 jars and fill them up with rice and then cover that rice with water to allow for the growing of bacteria, I suppose. Because not all bacteria is bad bacteria. And we're going to prove that some bacteria is just downright happy.
And in the nature of science, we will be having all 3 of our jars experience different emotions from us. One jar will be positive emotions and love and care. The second one will be neutral, where we experience no emotions for it, and it'll just exist as a jar of rice. And the last one, we will do our absolute hardest to make its life hell.
You know, I would say let's forego measuring specifically and just kind of try to fill half the jar. That seems to be
roughly halfway.
We're just gonna fill it roughly halfway.
We kind of have like measurements on it. There's like vertical. Can you see the horizontal lines?
Yeah. Second horizontal line. Okay, you got it. I mean, in science, they usually just kind of eyeball things. Measurements aren't really important.
You know, in most science experiments, they have goggles. So if you're going to be trying to make rice have feelings, wear some goggles.
How could I have been so careless?
Safety first, that's what they're always telling you. All right, now that we have our safety goggles on, we will continue to test.
I am so sorry about that. Okay, now we want just enough water to cover it. I suppose it's gonna get a little absorby over the month.
Rice is great at taking moisture in. Have you ever put your phone in rice?
I have, that actually works.
Maybe this rice can take in my love and my hatred, like it takes in water from my phone. Are you going to name your rice jars?
I'm not sure if I'm going to name them or as much as I'm going to convey an emotion on the label. All right, we made a little bit of a mess, but we got our rice in there, in their new aquatic homes.
Once you have all your rice ready, bust out labels or color pencils, markers, whatever you want to do to differentiate the bottles of jars from each other. And now that I have my labels made, I will name them.
All right, Donovan, what did you come up with?
So for my good boy jar, I guess if you want to call it, the good jar, I wrote a favorite, I love you jar, and I put a little emoji of a heart and a kissy face on there.
Honestly, I can tell you care about that jar.
This jar, it is going to experience heaven.
You're gonna show that jar the time of its life?
This jar, I think I already love it a lot.
You're gonna take it everywhere with you?
Probably. I think it's only fair for this jar. I mean, look at it. Look at how beautiful it is.
It is beautiful. So speaking of beautiful, and speaking of good boy, I named my good jar Good Boy.
Oh.
With a little smiley face.
And
I just love him. He is my good boy. He's very handsome.
Nice.
And we're gonna do the world. This one middle here, it's not applicable. I don't even want to talk about
it.
Right. This last jar here gets me heated just looking at it. So I just wrote, I hate you 6 times on it.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Look
at him, he's an idiot.
He is an idiot.
I feel the same way about my jar. I mean, I haven't let mine stand up since I've labeled it. It's just been, it's stupid. My neutral jar or my middle child jar, I just kind of put a neutral face on there to really experience how I feel about this jar. Just no emotion about this jar at all.
Just nothing.
And I don't mean that in a negative way. I just, no emotion towards this jar.
There's really nothing
to say. It's a jar. I mean, it holds stuff, I guess.
There's really nothing to say about it.
It's a jar.
So we're gonna take these to our own respective homes. Throughout the course of the month, we're gonna continue documenting this experiment separately. And we're gonna meet up in a month and compare our findings.
Any closing thoughts about the jars?
None at all, you?
I hate this one.
I hate this one. We'll see you in a month.
70 days later, and the rice experiment is finally ending. How do you feel, Tuesday?
I feel like I've made some pretty strong conclusions.
You'll notice that there are only 5 jars here. There was a tragic incident involving the bad jar on my end of the experiment. If we want to show that clip right here as I'm talking over it, you can see the jar is just absolutely murked on the floor of a boiler room.
And I think that's just karma, isn't it?
It was definitely poetic, for sure.
It was a bad rice jar, and it met a fitting end. So he can no longer be with us here today.
Man,
but
only 5 days into the experiment, and he decided to jump off of a tiny little shelf onto the concrete floor.
Couldn't take it anymore.
Couldn't take it.
This experiment was supposed to show varying mold levels, I think, depending on how well you treated each jar of rice. I think I am a skeptic here because, surprisingly, I don't have a bit of mold in any of these. Not even this jar.
Yeah, no, they look all the same. All the same shade of just white rice and water.
This jar right here, I said, I hate you two 5 times a day, every day for the last 70 days. This jar, on the other hand, went with me everywhere I went. It slept with me in bed, and I told him about how he is the best jar of rice I have ever seen in my life. And God, Donovan, I mean that. I really do mean that.
Yeah, no, I definitely neglected the bad jar enough to the point where he just didn't deal with it anymore.
Yeah.
But if we could show that video again, let's stop right here. Look at him on the floor. He is white. He is still white. He did not turn brown from the stress.
You know, you can tell he's just as ugly on the inside as he was on the outside. I am really disappointed. I wasn't really, you know, trusting this new age science, but this jar I've treated so finely looks exactly the same. And not a bit of mold in any of it.
I was pretty skeptical of the experiment when you told me about it the first time, but
I thought my good boy was going to evolve, you know, a higher form. And I thought this one was going to just, I thought my hate jar was just going to turn black, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They're your words manifesting physically or whatever.
Maybe we just didn't do it right. I mean,
or maybe it doesn't work. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate it.
Check out some more videos over here or subscribe to the channel.